Tuned in with your girls PVG of Nurse Notes. Tonight's show is going to be a little different. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about sexually transmitted infections. Formerly known as sexually transmitted diseases.
I could have went for infestations.
Oh my god.
Anyway,
when y'all see these pictures, them infestations.
Be prepared for a lot of information tonight.
Right. So if you haven't got your snacks and you haven't got your wine, we'll give you one more minute. Go get your stuff. Come back and chill with us.
Eat it now before you see them pictures.
Yeah.
Actually.
You are now tuned in with PBG of Nurse Notes.
Hi, I'm Pam.
I'm Veronica.
And I'm Gabby. And we are here to get you
notarized.
Catch our all new podcast
every Thursday night from 7 to 8 p.m.
on YouTube, Official Nurse Notes, and Villa Coola Radio.
You can also watch us on our website at www.officialnursenotes.com.
Please go like, follow, and share on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
See you there, Noties!
No, I can't. All right, Notiz, welcome back. Thank you so much for joining us for tonight's show. Gabby already told you what we're going to be talking about, sexually transmitted infections. Know your status. Mm-hmm. So we'll just go ahead and jump into our first topic. But before we do, hi, Stephanie. We just wanted to shout you
hi,
out.
Stephanie.
Thank you so much Bobby. For watching.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for the compliment. But y'all know how we roll. We always start out with the grand old statistics, right? We have to give you the numbers so you know what we're talking about, what we're working with. So per the CDC, 26 million new STIs in 2018, almost half of the new STIs mm-hmm. were among youth of ages 15 to 24 in the United States.
Yes. Watch these kids.
Yeah.
Yes.
15 to 24. This not even the grown folks. These are the people that...
Had a hot girl summer.
Listen, it was too hot. Hot down there and everywhere. Doing a little too much.
Mm-hmm.
In 2018, there were a total of 68 million infections with STIs. One in five people in the United States has an STI.
Mm-hmm.
And the new sexually transmitted infections total nearly $16 billion in direct medical costs.
Mm.
Yeah. So more than 2.5 million cases of chlamydia, gonorrhea, and syphilis were reported in 2019.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's all over the United States as a whole. That's a lot.
That is a
and we'll
lot.
Dive deeper into what each of those infections are. But as you see, that is an infestation.
Correct.
That could be like 68 million roaches.
Uh-huh.
Right. Oh, and I'm getting in trouble because we were supposed to come back and introduce ourselves. So let's run it back for just 1 second.
Run it back.
Hey, y'all. I'm Pam.
I'm Veronica.
And I'm Gabby.
And we are here to get you notarized. Okay. So
we know you missed it. We know. Gonna comment. They
somebody
didn't
was
the
like,
intro.
I didn't do it. We did it. Okay. So, y'all, basically, sexually transmitted infections are sexually transmitted diseases. They changed the name. I can't remember why.
I think it was about 2017.
Yeah, it's just been a few years ago. I can't remember the reason.
It's
the
new.
Same thing. I think disease has more of a chronic
right. That's what I was gonna
terminology.
Say. Right.
And so infection is usually more acute. Which
treatable.
Which is, yeah, long-term, short-term, I don't know. But it's the same thing, y'all. Mm-hmm. The same sexually transmitted diseases that have been around for years, they're still here. But a lot of them have come back with a vengeance and a force. So the first ones that we're going to talk about are the bacterial strains, which are the ones that can be cured with antibiotics.
Right.
And hot off the press is chlamydia.
Chlamydia?
Yes.
Go ahead. Break it down.
One of the most common STIs that may be asymptomatic and requires a medical diagnosis. When there are symptoms, you typically have painful urination, genital discharge from penis or vagina. Actually, eye discharge, spotting, which is, you know, traces of faint blood in underwear. But from my understanding, it's typically asymptomatic. You really need to get
For most women, especially women. 90% of women do not have symptoms. And if they do, especially things like the eye boogers, they think it's sinus
mm-hmm.
and things like that, they don't even realize it's coming from an infection that's been sitting and just
festering
around for a long time, not being cured. So, yeah, that ought to kind of, I don't know, that made my stomach hurt a little bit, and I'm a nurse. So it
right.
ought to make some people feel some type of way. Now, for men, they did some studies, the CDC, and a lot of men say they instantly, within 24 hours, when they come in contact with chlamydia, they feel a burning urination or a
mm-hmm.
burning sensation in the penis. But every man is different. So, I mean, but for the most part, it's asymptomatic, y'all.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people could be burning a man.
Oh,
yes.
Lord have mercy.
She's burning on the truth for a man.
The scary thing about chlamydia is it can cause permanent damage to a woman's reproductive system. That can make it difficult for a woman to have
children later.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to say is if you're having sexual activity, no matter what age you are, and you're having unprotected sex, a lot of these diseases, you don't have, some women don't have symptoms, and men. Mm-hmm. So you should be getting frequent checks. I mean, I would just really say wrap it up and still get checked out.
You really, anytime you're in a relationship, during the relationship, after the relationship, if you having one night stands, if you having, what they call it, flybys and all this
hot
stuff.
Hot parties. Ooh. I don't know. Oh, all these new terms.
Let's not get on the parties.
All these new terms.
I mean, but you could be in a monogamous relationship with somebody.
That's what I'm saying. You during the relationship, after, before, you always need to check.
Mm-hmm. And one thing, women, you may not have the burning symptoms. You may not have the eye discharge. But you will notice a change in the pH of your vagina. You just got to pay attention. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times, if you're a woman and you don't wear panty liners or something daily in your underwear.
Or panties.
You can tell by the You can tell by the acidity in your underwear that something is off with your discharge.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to be going to the doctor to get swabbed and get it checked out.
Yes.
Because it could be chlamydia. It could, it could be a sexually transmitted
infection. Your panties should look like you just bought them.
Yeah.
Not like they've been ran through.
Yeah.
And the reason
if you put your underwear in the dirty clothes and they stand up when you walk away,
you go right now.
That's a problem.
If you smell a fishy odor.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Instead of talking about, I will say, we always joke. Instead of talking about, people say, hey, do you notice?
Yeah.
Especially if it's a friend, like, hey,
if that's your friend,
hey, do you?
Girl, when you sit down, your wind is killing me. Are you okay?
Are you okay?
That sit down wind is the toughest one.
And if you're the person receiving the information, take it seriously. You probably gonna joke it off because you're embarrassed. Take it seriously and go to the doctor.
Yeah.
Okay? It's not gonna clear with apple cider vinegar. Here we go again. It's not gonna clear with douching. You shouldn't be doing that.
First of all, nobody should be douching, but we're gonna do a show on that later. So we're gonna keep moving on. What? Know that chlamydia can cause ectopic pregnancy, which can be fatal.
Mm-hmm. Right.
To you. So if you have a pregnancy outside of the uterus, you can die from that.
Yes.
So it's really important for you to keep up with your OBGYN appointments. Especially if you are sexually active, whether you are in a monogamous or multiple relationships, you need to be getting checked, okay? But honestly, per the CDC, the only way to really avoid STIs is not to have any type of sex.
Mm-hmm.
And y'all need to know that chlamydia is not just vaginal transfer. You can get it orally and anally.
Yes.
So there are three methods of transfer for chlamydia. It is a bacteria. It's going to sit. It's going to grow. All in hot areas,
and
right?
I'm going to say any place you can put something can grow there.
Exactly.
So all of that needs to be checked. Yes.
Exactly.
We're going to be serious on this
show. And if you're
going
to wear condoms, wear them correctly.
Yes.
If you are a well-endowed man, shop in the large penis section.
Yes.
Don't wear medium lifestyle condoms.
Baby, it's not
you're putting
work.
Yourself and the person that you're sleeping with at risk. Vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
If you are less endowed, stop buying Magnums because you're hanging out with your homeboys and you're trying to front and using these things and getting these women pregnant and getting diseases and stuff. It matters. It makes a difference because they can have holes in them.
Mm-hmm.
They can be defective.
They can
you
slip
just
off.
You really need to educate yourself about what you're doing to protect yourself. It really is serious business, and we're going to talk real matter of fact about it, okay? The treatment for chlamydia is antibiotics, okay? And that simple is that right now it is curable.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on to that.
Stick a pin there.
Yeah,
now,
hold
if
on
you
to that.
Do have chlamydia and you are taking antibiotics, it's important to remember to take the whole prescription.
Yes.
Don't start feeling better, smelling better, thinking you're doing better.
Mm-hmm.
No, because then you can cause resistance if you stop taking your antibiotics early.
Super germs, y'all.
Yes,
right. Super germs. We'll get there.
Yeah, so the next on the hot bacterial strand list is good old gonorrhea.
Old school.
Gonorrhea been around since they've been calling it the clap.
Oh, yes.
Now it's clapping back.
Clapping back, baby, with
you
a bitch.
You understand me? Gonorrhea is not playing any games. Did y'all know that there are multiple strands?
Yes.
Let me be clear.
For
multiple
real.
Strands of gonorrhea that are antibiotic resistant.
That's a problem.
You cannot cure them. It's just like having HIV.
Yes.
You with me, you stuck with me.
Yes.
That's how
that's the
bad
gift that keeps on giving.
Yes, yeah. For the rest of your life, you're stuck with it. And in Dallas County, out of all of the counties in Texas,
all of them,
they are running the highest numbers for the antibiotic-resistant gonorrhea. So y'all need to be protecting yourself. It's another bacterial infection.
Right.
It's caused by having unprotected sex with someone who is infected, okay? Mm-hmm. It does the same things as chlamydia. Mm-hmm. It can keep you from being able to have children if you are a woman. For men, it can infect your urethra and cause problems later on in life, such as infertility for men as well. You may be asymptomatic to gonorrhea, you know, especially women. So it's the same principle, y'all. Just because you don't see it doesn't mean it's not there. Just because you don't feel it doesn't mean it's not there.
And we have to stop thinking that way.
Yes.
We need to go get tested. We need to see the paper that shows you what you're being tested for. We'll get
the last time you
tested, we'll get there.
You need to be looking. Turn the lights on. You need to check that thing. My mama said, look at the under, the wink of the stink of the everything.
And I'm
make sure
say
you don't
for
see
2021,
no,
you look
to
at the paper.
Ruler to the tuta and the paper.
And the paper.
Now, if you do have symptoms as a woman, you may notice painful sexual intercourse. So pain during sex. It won't just be burning. Women don't usually burn. It's the men that have the burning sensation in the penis. Women will have
cramps,
abnormal
right?
discharge and cramps.
Yellow
we just talked. Yeah, it's a
yellow
green, nasty looking color. You're gonna know that something is. Let me rephrase that.
Yes.
You should know something is wrong because the yellow and green discharge should not be coming from the vagina.
No
now,
rainbows.
The gonorrhea strands that are in the throat now, you will see pus coming out of your throat.
Mm-hmm.
So you should know that if you hock up some spit and you see a thin, watery-like substance that might have a little blood, a little yellow tinge color to it, that's pus. And that is
and it can be the cause of halitosis.
Exactly.
Just
which
throwing
is,
that out
which
there.
Which is really
bad
breath. And just know that you can have gonorrhea of the rectum as well.
Anywhere you can. Let me not say
you,
it.
It's, and it's
anybody
like,
or
it's serious business. Painful bowel movements, itching in the anal area that is constant and unfulfilled even if you scratch. That is a sign of gonorrhea in the rectum. So yeah, y'all know it's spread by vaginal, anal, or oral sex. So you got to be protecting yourself because one thing about the mouth, there's no condom for that.
Yeah.
You got to think about it.
Yeah.
Gonorrhea is usually treated with antibiotics, but since it's been so resistant lately,
they're having a hard time.
They're running out of medications to use.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
This is serious. And again,
really
Dallas
is.
County.
Yeah. Yeah. So, last on the list, y'all, of the bacterial strands is syphilis.
Old school again.
Syphilis is one of those. It's like we tell y'all high blood pressure is a silent killer all the time. This one is real silent.
Real.
The only thing that you might see is something called a chancre. Can we get a photograph of the chancre, please?
And please brace yourself. These are very informative.
Okay. This is what a chancre of the penis will look like. You can see the indentation. You can see the sore. And you can see the cells that are deteriorating on the inside of that chancre. It's just that one sore. And it looks, you know, like something you should go get checked out. But you wouldn't believe the number of people look at that and think, oh, maybe I rub something.
Out of denial.
You need to go to the doctor. Women can have this.
Uh-huh.
Inside the vagina only. So don't be thinking that because you don't see the chancre on the outside of the vagina that it's not there. It's internal for the women, and it can only be seen when you go and have your exam with an OBGYN with the speculum.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? It's bacterial, like I said. The sore is there. You can get those in your mouth on the rectum as well. But syphilis, y'all, it's an old school disease that's coming back into this century with a force. The numbers in the last year have more than tripled. And it's by stages. So when you're in the first stage or the primary stage of syphilis, you can get cured. You can get medication.
Right.
And But as you progress on and you don't get treatment, it's stuck with you just like HIV or the viral strands. And when you get all the way to the last stage, it can even cause your organs to shut down and brain damage.
So basically what you're saying, if you were, you know, sexually active at 17 and for some reason at 32 you never got tested, now you have tertiary syphilis for life.
Yeah. Okay. And it can take you out.
I just want to make it very clear to the viewers.
Exactly.
But as a woman, that's why you should be doing your annual exams and talking to your doctor about your sexual activity and be very honest with them.
Exactly.
And they're not there to judge you.
And please know that syphilis takes 3 to 90 days to even show you a chancre. Mm-hmm. If you get it. So you could be walking around for 3 whole months.
Yeah.
With syphilis carrying along, eating with you, napping with you, sleeping with you,
girl,
and your friends, and whatever else you have going on, if it's there and you don't know, you don't know. So you have to go get your exams. Women that are sexually active like that, y'all need to be going every 3 months to see your OBGYN. I'm sorry, I don't care if you're married or not. You need to pop up in there and get tested. Men, it's painful. I understand. A lot of men do not want to go and have a Q-tip. I understand. As a woman, when you with your man, stop lying. Ladies, if you have a disease, you need to go tell the man or the man that you're sleeping with so he can get treated too.
Yeah.
That way he doesn't have to go through all of that.
Yeah.
If you know you're having unprotected sex with people, then you need to let them know if you are diagnosed with something. You need to be honest about it.
So wrap it up. Keep your mouth off each other. Kissing can't get you pregnant, like Mr. Brown said. We're going to cut to commercial, and we'll be right back to see you guys. Welcome, Notees. You are now tuned in with PVG of Nurse Notes.
Hi, I'm Pam.
I'm Veronica.
And I'm Gabby. And we are here to get you notarized. Tune in to our brand new podcast, Official Nurse Notes, on Thursdays from 7 to 8.
Where we'll share our personal journeys as nurses in healthcare
to help bring access and support to the communities around us.
Make sure you tune in because this show is gonna be lit.
See you there, Notees.
All right, Notees. Thank you so much for coming back from that quick commercial break. We're going to go ahead and jump into our first segment of the evening, which is Back to the Basics.
And that is sponsored by Visionary CPR, Erica Hall, American Heart Certified Instructor. If you need your BLS, ACLS, PALS, or Heart Saver Certification renewal, no problem. She's your girl. She will work with your schedule. Call her at 469-657-4200 or look at her website at www.cpr-vhcs.com. Thanks, Erica.
Thank you, Erica.
All right, y'all. So back to the basics.
Back to the what?
Back. All right, you guys. So for this segment, we wanted to provide you guys with a video from directly from the CDC about the gonorrhea that is antibiotic resistant. It's really good information, so it's only 3 minutes. Please take the time and listen.
Mm-hmm. Gonorrhea is a major public health concern in the United States. More than 1 million new infections occur each year, but because many people don't have symptoms, fewer than half are detected and reported to CDC. Untreated gonorrhea can cause serious health problems. It can increase the risk of a life-threatening ectopic pregnancy, cause conditions that can lead to infertility, and increase a person's risk of getting or giving HIV. Medication to treat gonorrhea has been around for decades, but the bacteria has grown resistant to nearly every drug ever used to treat it. In the 1980s, resistance to penicillin and tetracycline grows, and they are no longer recommended to treat gonorrhea. Fluoroquinolones are the leading drugs to treat gonorrhea in the 1990s, but the bacteria was adapting to the drugs. CDC modifies treatment for much of the next decade to keep pace with resistance. In 2000, the drug is no longer recommended to treat people infected in Asia or the Pacific Islands. By 2002, this recommendation extends to California, and then in 2004, to men who have sex with men throughout the United States. By 2007, widespread fluoroquinolone resistance leaves only one class of antibiotics, cephalosporins, to treat the infection. In 2010, CDC recommends adding a second drug, either azithromycin or doxycycline, to the treatment regimen to protect cephalosporins from resistance. But just 2 years later, in 2012, CDC must update treatment recommendations again when data suggests the oral cephalosporin, cefixime, is becoming less effective at treating gonorrhea. As of 2020, CDC no longer recommends azithromycin due to emerging resistance that could threaten its ability to treat other common infections. Gonorrhea is becoming harder and harder to treat. Today, a single injection of the cephalosporin, ceftriaxone, is essentially all that stands between us and untreatable gonorrhea. Our last treatment option won't last forever. A difficult-to-treat strain of gonorrhea has been reported in the U.S., and broader surveillance shows half of all infections are resistant to at least one antibiotic. The U.S. hasn't seen a treatment failure with the recommended treatment, but drug resistance is rising, and the pipeline for new drugs isn't keeping up. Prevention, testing, and effective treatment are needed now more than ever. We must keep drug-resistant gonorrhea as a leading priority. Learn more at cdc.gov/std/gonorrhea/ARG.
All right, No Tease. We hope you took the time to listen all the way through to that very informative video from the CDC. You can always go to the CDC website, and you can go to the search bar and type in any sexually transmitted infection or disease. And when I tell you, it is a wealth of information on there, way more than Google, mm-hmm. way more detail.
And accurate.
Yes, and it can direct you. If you want to go in on there and type in you want to know statistics for the area you live in, you can get that from the CDC.
And if you want to see what's popping and dropping in your area, go to your local county health department site.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
It'll tell you what's trending in your area.
Yeah, especially.
Not in a good way, but.
Exactly.
But you need to be informed of what's going on in your community.
You do, especially if you know you sleep around with multiple people. We're not judging.
At all.
We're just telling you, if you're going to do it, protect yourself.
Be safe, be smart, and be informed.
Exactly.
Like what Tamika say, a whole lot of pleasure can cause a whole lot of pain.
Yes, ma'am.
Exactly.
Hey, Tamika.
Look, Betty tried to tell us that a little bit of pleasure is worth a whole lot of pain. Betty lied to y'all.
She was desperate.
It's not worth it, because you can go out here in these streets and bring something to the house, to the person that you with, or other people that you're sleeping with. If you sleep with multiple people, that you can't take it back out the house.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to be seriously taking into consideration other people when you make sexual decisions.
Prevention, treatment, protection.
Exactly. Exactly.
All this, you know, we gonna, you know, hot girl summer and all that, for real. You need a monogamous partner. You need to be with somebody that's gonna be with you and only you, because you floating around in these streets, you gonna catch something.
Yeah, and gonorrhea, if y'all listen to that video, for years, it has outgrown every single medication that has been thrown at it.
Yeah. That means and it's killer.
It's not the bug. Mm-hmm. It's y'all. Yeah. It is the people.
It's the people.
Because
that's
you get it. They give you the medicine. You keep an antibiotics for when you get a cold later in the year.
Yeah.
First of all, a cold is a virus, and antibiotics can't help it anyway.
Yeah.
Take your damn medicine.
Yeah.
The whole 14 days.
It's not going to help my sniffles nights.
No. Take all your medicine. The burning stop. Oh, I ain't burning no more. Let me save these pills for a toothache.
You know why they don't take all the medicine? Because they're hiding it.
Exactly. What are you doing that for? All you're doing is creating a super bug. which is what we have now because it is resistant to every antibiotic.
All right. So we're going to talk about one more bacterial infection, which is the trichomoniasis, before we jump into viruses real quick. I mean, it's so much information in this episode, y'all.
It was just too much to get in that first topic.
Back to the website.
But, y'all, trichomoniasis, I have a photo. We have a photo. If we can get it up there. Trichomoniasis, if you look at this slide, if you go into the doctor's office and you're diagnosed with trichomoniasis, this is what your doctor is looking at. They made it colorful for you, but that's what it looks like under the microscope. Those are literal bugs inside of your uterus. Because they swab the cervix and that's where the discharge comes from. And those fomites, that's what they're called, are alive inside. It's like having internal crabs.
That's what I was.
Y'all know what crabs are.
Yeah.
Well, that's what these are. Trichomoniasis, y'all. And this is the thing about it. It is the most prevalent non-viral STI in the world. It affects approximately 3.7 million people in the United States. And because it's not a reportable disease, these are just the ones that were reported. They don't have to report this. Okay. Yeah. So, listen, and the black community, y'all, is the most infected and affected by trichomoniasis. It is getting to the point where the medicines that they use for it are not even curing it, and people are having trichomoniasis for the rest of their life. So, you're going to walk around with bugs inside your body for the rest of your life if you are not doing the things that you need to do. Because if you, the problem with trichomoniasis is reinfection. It's one of those, if you keep getting it, it's going to stick around with you.
Yeah. And whoever you're sticking to.
Yes. And it's so noticeable. Ladies, for y'all, it is a very fishy, smelly odor in your underwear. As a matter of fact, it smells so bad, people can smell you when you open your legs. It's very pungent.
Sounds familiar.
It's very pungent.
Does it?
And it smells terribly. And when you go into the doctor's office, the solution that they use to put with it, to test for it, it will smell up the whole doctor's office. That's how disgusting, I'm sorry, that particular STI is. I mean, and they use metronidazole. That is the key treatment for trichomoniasis, which is also called trich, but it's getting to the point where women are having to go months and months on that medication because this one is actually not a bacteria. It's not a bacteria. It's a bug.
It's like a parasite. And if you're not telling your partner and y'all are still having sexual relations, you will just constantly reinfect each other, which is probably another reason we have a mega bug on our hands.
Exactly.
Because y'all are going back and forth, then you go into somebody else, then back and forth. It's all like a big, what they say, the 6 degrees?
Yeah.
It's the same thing. You know, it's like a big circle. So it's a big circle of trick.
And just know, uncircumcised men, y'all are at a higher risk of contracting trichomoniasis.
So you have to pull the skin back
and you need to be paying attention to it and you need to be using some protection because you are at a high risk of keeping the bacteria inside and continuously giving it to your mate to the point where you can't even be cured.
Scrub the folds.
So, that thing shouldn't have no smell either.
You're right, Gabby. That's the other thing. Men, if you have trichomoniasis, you can smell that fishy odor from your penis.
Mm-hmm.
So you may not ever smell it, but when your woman, I don't know what all y'all do, at some point a woman is going to come in contact with your penis. She can smell that.
Yeah.
She needs to be telling you that it's some smelly odor down there, and it's very strong.
Your mama didn't teach you to smell yourself, smell your wing.
Not all of them.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So y'all need to take it serious. Get your physical exams. Keep up to date on these things. And if you do have it, treat your male partner and let him know so he can go to his primary care and get a dose for men.
Mm-hmm.
Men have a different dose of the medicine because they have to take it orally. It cannot be put inside of the penis.
But if you tell your doctor once you have one of these diseases, they will give you the antibiotic prescription for your mate.
Exactly.
So, viruses.
Exactly. So we're going to go ahead and end that segment, back to the basics, and jump into topic number two. Lifelong contract. If you F with me, you stuck with me. These are the ones that
you can't
are the gifts that keep on giving.
That's right.
You can't. There's no cure for these viral strains. And first on the list is the most prevalent one, and it is genital herpes or HSV2. You might hear people saying herpes simplex virus number 2. Herpes simplex virus number 1 is usually is fever blisters. It's of the mouth. 2 is genital. So there is a difference. It's transmitted just like any other sexually transmitted infection, anal, oral, or vaginal sex with someone who is infected. One of the key things that Pam told me not to forget to let y'all know about herpes, when you go into the doctor, 9 times out of 10, I'm going to tell you 10 times out of 10. Because I've worked in the doctor's offices. Your doctor is not going to test you for genital herpes unless you ask. You have to request that test. And one of the main reasons is your insurance will not pay for it. Okay? Now, if you're pregnant and you're going to the doctor, they test for everything. They're going to test for herpes and the insurance is going to pay. But if you can't tell that insurance some reason, like if you don't already have like HIV or hepatitis, some other major
viral,
then they're not going to test you for herpes. So you need to say, hey, doc, I want to be checked for herpes. The doctor's going to say, oh, well, why? Oh, well, because I want to be checked. You don't have to explain that.
Don't worry about that. Go ahead and get that test. And
get the test.
Make sure that when you're going in for your checkup that you actually see HSV 1 and 2 tested.
Yes.
One more thing, HSV 1 oral herpes can actually be transmitted to genital. So
yes. So if you have it in your mouth and you're having you oral sex, then you can
transmit
give someone, it can transmit to HSV 2. So yeah, if you have symptoms, we do have some pictures to show you. Of genital herpes, of what it could look like.
Do it with the lights on. You're gonna get
So that's nasty. I don't know how y'all feel about it, but that gives me the heebie-jeebies. And those are really bad cases, and no one is excluded from that.
And we also want to point out some types are preventable by a vaccine. And I know we ain't going to talk about vaccines, baby, but, you know, HPV was one of the vaccines that was so controversial because they wanted to be able to administer it to our children without our permission. So it's just one of those, it's one of those things that, you know.
Exactly. And the other thing about herpes is you can have herpes for 10 years.
Yes.
And never, ever, ever
and it lay dormant.
Know it.
Yes.
It'll stay in your system.
Dormant.
And you never have a breakout. But just know that just because you're not having a breakout, you're still doing what they call shedding. Which means you're still giving it to other people. So you're walking around with herpes and spreading it around to any and everybody because you don't know you have it. So you need to be requesting that test every time you go. Now, there's not a cure, but there are CDC recommended regimens for herpes. Acyclovir, you may have seen Valtrex on the commercials. That's pretty popular. That's what that is. These are the recommended doses that they have. You can go check that out on the CDC. All it does is really minimize the symptoms. It does not kill the virus. Just know that.
Right.
And it doesn't stop you from shedding or passing it along. So you can still take Baltrex and still pass along herpes. Okay? You got to know that.
And we'll just have to do HIV in its own show.
It is so much information just couldn't.
We won't even touch that. Also, like, let's tell these people, like, not only do you, we always say primary care physician. I know everybody don't have one, but you can Google free testing sites in your area. There's clinics, free clinics in different neighborhoods. You can go to the health department in your city. So you need to be finding ways to get tested. Not you just don't have to have a doctor. So don't be like, oh, I don't have a doctor, I can't get tested.
Or I don't have insurance.
Yeah. You can also go
you can do private testing at home.
I about to say private testing at home. You can do freestanding testing sites. It may be more expensive, but you can also do that. And they have like different packages for different prices.
But most of the clinics, the rural health clinics, they will do a lot of that testing for free for you.
Planned Parenthood.
So, don't be ashamed.
Men and women.
Even if the line is long. No, there's no excuse, y'all.
None.
You just really need to know your status.
Be accountable.
And be an adult.
Yeah. If we're out here, if we're out here freaking, you need to go out there and get tested, too.
Yeah. Exactly.
I'm going to call it thing a thing.
It is what it is.
So the next one, HPV?
Human papillomavirus. If you haven't heard of it, genital warts is what it causes. It's not the same as genital warts. Genital warts is still its own thing. But the human papillomavirus can cause genital warts. And not just on your private parts. As you can see, you can get it on your tongue.
You can get it in your throat.
You can get them on your anus. And you can get them on your regular body parts.
Yes, your lips.
Yeah. So, it, y'all, it's not a game. There are more than 3 million cases a year of HPV in the United States. The thing about it is, it's like a double-edged sword, y'all. Sword. It can cause cancer. That looks so disgusting. I'm sorry. And then you think somebody's teeth is like this because they need to go to the dentist, all the while they walking around with HPV all in your mouth trying to kiss you and stuff. Y'all better stop kissing everybody.
Kissing gets you
kissing
pregnant.
Kissing is the cause of a lot of things.
This looks worse than the kissing bug. If you never seen that, look it up.
Remember the cooties?
It was real. It was
cooties
a real thing.
A real thing. That's all this stuff.
Now, HPV is a little different from these other ones, y'all, because it can go away on its own. But if it sticks around, it can cause cancer and those warts. And I think we have some genital wart pictures for you to see.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Why are they glittering?
Yeah.
I'm going to pull him from back there.
Man.
And again, you know.
Do it with the lights on.
I knew she was going to say that.
Because they lights. Because you can see that. You can see that.
No, lights, camera, paper. Yeah. Look at the paper.
You can see that. It's no
lights
reason.
Don't do nothing. Look at that paper.
Yeah.
I'm telling you now.
You
see, my mom showed me this, and I was like, baby, listen.
And you know, back in the day, they showed us these things in school, and it scared us half to death.
Yeah.
But now they don't even touch on this in school
so
anymore.
So please, if you have a young, any
teach
person, but young
kids.
Person, go ahead and share this video, because
parents,
this is
like,
very accurate.
Take your job back. Really, like, we did learn in school, but these numbers is way worse than when I was a kid. I'm not even finna age myself, because baby, I'm 25 today. But I'm just saying, like, these are things that you do need to have conversations with your kids about. You need to show them. I mean, we was having a conversation. One of my nieces, I ain't going to call them out because I don't want their friends to get mad, but like, they was calling me and they cutting it up, acting like these diseases is something that they should have.
Yeah.
No, this is not a McDonald's hamburger, baby. You should not have that. And
no, these teenagers
they
don't
have
it. They're on another level with it. Like, I saw some things on social media a couple of years ago when my daughter was still in high school and these girls were arguing and she was like, but you got chlamydia. She was like, so I had it twice. Like, I mean, it's like, it's these children think it's something that, I don't know, but y'all need to be talking to them.
Because when you become a mature woman and you want to have kids, you may have difficulties having a baby.
Well, and who is marrying these? Okay, never mind.
We don't go there. But, yeah. I mean, I wonder, was, you know, like in Oklahoma, I don't know if it's still a rule, so don't get me the Oklahomans. But, you know, you used to have to get all these STD panels before you got married. I was like, I don't know what
back
they was
in the
afraid
day.
Of. Like,
they stopped it.
A good thing. Because, I mean, I probably would
blood
kill
tests.
You.
Yeah.
They did all kinds of blood tests back in the day.
It's
in
a
Texas.
Good idea to keep doing that, folks.
I think so.
Before you marry him, test him. Before you lay with him.
Or her.
Yeah, they got swabs. Y'all can swab each other and put it on the table. Throw your status down, baby.
some of these people swinging trichomoniasis around the pole. Y'all better watch yourself. HPV can cause cervical cancer, mm-hmm. cancer of the vulva, of the vagina, vaginal cancer, mm-hmm. and penile cancer. Mm-hmm. Yes, you can get cancer of the penis.
And anal cancer. Let's not forget that. Yes.
And you don't want that. Yeah. You're going to get a bag
anywhere
in the belly.
HPV can touch, it can cause cancer there.
You're going to be pooping out your stomach.
Exactly.
Yeah. When they said babies of the throat.
Yes. So if you're going to be sexually active, that means you need to be safe. But you need to be getting checked.
And let's be clear. Don't be going down and around eating up the stuff in the front and the back and then trying to put on a condom. What did you accomplish with that?
Yeah.
You didn't put your mouth on it.
And that's how we got
And then you're going to wrap it up? Did that make sense to you? How did that make sense?
Everything you put your mouth or something in, you need to get it checked.
There's mucus. Then you can get a disease. Yeah.
And
come on now.
If somebody going to do you in the bathroom at the club, probably got something tricky.
Yeah, don't do that.
I try to tell somebody, your game ain't that strong, player.
Don't do that.
That's just what she do.
Gabby just got us in trouble.
Again.
So we're going to go ahead and go pay a few bills.
We're going to pay some bills.
Check some comments because we know y'all have some.
You are now tuned in with PBG of Nurse Notes.
Hi, I'm Pam.
I'm Veronica.
And I'm Gabby. And we are here to get you
notarized.
Catch our all-new podcast
every Thursday night from 7 to 8 p.m.
on YouTube, Official Nurse Notes, and Villa Cooler Radio.
You can also watch us on our website at www.officialnursenotes.com.
Please go like, follow, and share on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
See you there, Notees!
If you came back after all that, thank you.
We appreciate it.
We're going to go ahead and jump into our second segment of the night, which is the health information tip of the week, brought to you by none other than the 817 crew.
817, yes.
817 Manicure Studio.
Hey, Ashley.
What's up, Ashley?
What's up, Bri?
817 Barbershop. What's up, Bri?
Hey.
817 Barbershop Classic, you guys, 2220 South Boyne Road in Arlington, Texas. Y'all hit up Breon, 817-303-4912. I heard he's the best to do it out of 817. Y'all go check him out.
Y'all got me wanting to shave the side of my head.
You know, just
so
a little design or something.
A little bit.
And then go get your nails done.
Right. Welcome back, Notees. It's time for Nurse Notes Hits of the Week. I need a hit. Yeah.
All right, Notees, welcome back. We're going to go ahead and jump into this good old health information tip of the week. And this one is pregnancy and sexually transmitted infections, y'all. So we've told you guys that all of these infections can cause women to be barren or infertile, men to be infertile and things like that. But some of these people are already living with these infections, and they need to know that when they become pregnant, they can pass along every single thing that we talked about to their unborn child.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it can complicate their pregnancy and cause health problems for them and their baby.
Right.
Yeah. Some of them can cause birth defects. I've seen a lot of them coming into the clinic, and you think babies born addicted to crack, see a baby born with syphilis.
Mm-hmm.
It's very sad. They have tremors. It was just a terrible thing to see. So of course the bacterial ones, they can give you antibiotics during your pregnancy.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are pregnant and you become infected during your pregnancy, you can be cured of chlamydia and gonorrhea if you get the strand that's curable.
Remember,
early treatment.
And syphilis, if they catch it early, and trichomoniasis. Mm-hmm. But if you get HIV, HPV, or herpes, mm-hmm. yeah, you're not getting any treatment for that. They're those medications that they give you to keep down the viral load in your system, you can't have during pregnancy. And a lot of times they will deliver by C-section.
That's right, to prevent transmission of the infection.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And the thing about it is, you could die in childbirth.
Yeah, just from that increases your risk.
From having an STI, and especially, you know, one that is stuck with you for life. It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible thing to see. So take the steps to protect yourself. If you know that you are going to try and get pregnant, please go to the doctor first. A lot of women start trying and they don't go to the doctor first. Mm-hmm. Go get screened for everything before you even put that on a baby.
And get him screened. Yeah. Don't just be thinking that you banking on knowing that he's just your man.
Yeah.
I told y'all about that bathroom.
Yeah.
It sounds like you're talking about Bucky's.
Bucky's bathroom is clean, but I'm just saying, don't be bucking in it.
Listen, if you're pregnant and you feel like something is going on, you have any of the symptoms of STIs, you tell your OBGYN super quick, fast, and in a hurry.
And if they ask me a question, you low-key need another one.
Yeah.
I mean, and that's our job as investigators, y'all. They gonna ask you some questions, but you should be really, if you're big enough to do it, be true to it. I mean, if you was popping it,
their stories where providers actually try to push people away from certain tests. That's what I'm
saying. Oh, that part. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah.
You need to be tested.
Stand firm. I want the whole panel.
Advocate for yourself.
Earth thing.
Let's talk about PID.
Oh, pelvic inflammatory disease.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You said you was gonna talk about it.
Oh, I thought we did. Sure is it.
So Pam is not playing today. So we're gonna go ahead and jump into the next topic.
The next topic.
Which is in case you missed it, mm-hmm. just because it doesn't appear doesn't mean it's not there. And like Pam said, pelvic inflammatory disease is first and hot on the list.
Mm, PID.
So there's a misconception about what it really is. I think growing
Did you
up,
say
every
misconception?
It is. That's a nursing school joke, but I had to throw that in there for Pam.
TLAC class of 2 years.
So basically, it's not just from tampons. I think that is something that has been told to our generation for years and years and years. Mm-hmm. Oh, if you wear tampons, you're going to get PID. Actually, it's not just one thing. It's a broad spectrum of inflammatory disorders of the upper female genital tract, and it can cause endometritis, salpingitis, tubal or ovarian excess, and pelvic peritonitis. So a whole lot of inflammations. Anytime you hear itis on the end of the word, it's inflamed, it's infected. It can be acute. And it's so difficult to diagnose, y'all. Mm-hmm. Really take some time and go out on the CDC website and read about it, because it takes a lot for them to diagnose it. So sometimes, a lot of the time, it is missed in the beginning. And by the time they catch it, you have to be treated in the hospital.
And if you've been watching our shows, it's like why I always say abdominal pain can have multiple diagnoses, because some women just have abdominal pain.
Exactly.
And if you're not honest in saying that you're sexually active, the doctor's not going to test you for it.
Or exactly. You're not honest and tell them when the last time you actually had a cervical exam.
You're right.
Exactly.
And it looks like this can actually be missed on laparoscopy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And this is the other thing. Men can carry pelvic inflammatory disease bacteria in their penis. Mm-hmm. So that's why I said it's important to know it's not just from wearing tampons long term. No. Don't get me wrong. If you're wearing tampons and you have a heavy period, you need to wear a tampon that is for a heavy period. You should not be wearing a super tampon during your lightest days of your cycle, because you can get pelvic inflammatory disease from those tampons. My advice, there are a lot of organic tampons out there now. People have stepped up their game. So all those chemicals that were previously on the tampons, they're not there. I recommend Honey Pot. I don't use them, but their stuff is the bomb. So if you're looking to get away from those other ones, I think that is a safe jump over. Okay. Was that all the key points that we wanted to hit on that?
Thanks.
Yes.
So.
Okay, so our next key point is going to be bacterial vaginosis. It's also called BV.
BV.
Or Gardnerella. Mm-hmm. Not Cinderella.
Gardnerella.
You don't want to hang out with Gardnerella.
Cinderella cut it
up
one time.
Gardnerella, the symptoms are almost exactly like trichomoniasis, so you have to be careful. It does require a diagnosis. We do have a graphic to show you what the differences are between the two. Bacterial vaginosis has a fishy odor. They say trichomoniasis is more musty, but actually they both stink like hell. I'm telling you now. You
like
will
hell.
Know.
It's going to be a whiff.
Yeah, you're going to know. And when they swab it and they in the doctor's office, the people down the hall smell you and they know that you're the person. Listen, it's embarrassing.
But you need to get it checked out.
Exactly. The discharge is a little bit different. So, you know, one is thin and off-white for the vaginosis. Trichomoniasis is a little more green and watery. Sometimes with BV, you can you won't notice painful urination and things like that, like you can with trichomoniasis.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, the vulvar irritation is present on both.
Irritation.
Really? Tell them what can cause the bacterial vaginosis.
Mm-hmm. First on the list is douching.
Yeah.
So it's 2021, ladies. We're gonna have a whole show about women's health. But if you're douching in 2021, please take the douche back to the dollar store and get your money back.
How you know it's from the dollar store?
Because most of the time, it's not really in Walmart anymore.
You noticed that? Okay.
They're not, and when it is, it's some off-brand I never heard of, Priceline or something. I don't know.
We see that blue and white.
You just stop douching. It's not a necessity.
We know your mama's taught you.
You are killing all of the good flora inside the vagina. So
it's
when
so
something
crazy.
Invades it that is foreign, there's nothing to fight it off. And so now you have bacterial vaginosis.
Or
BV.
You're killing the protection.
Yeah, and so it can cause painful intercourse too. So that may be another symptom that you have, and you may not have the odor. But if you carry BV long enough, you're going to smell that. It's going to be a very unpleasant discharge in your underwear, and it's going to be acidic. That's something they don't tell you. We talked about the underwear standing up in the room when you walk away. You probably got some BV going on.
I got a couple things.
Exactly. And BV is one of those things. It can cause problems, too, during your pregnancy. It can cause low birth weight of your child. And people walk around with it because the doctor's not testing for it because you're not saying this or that. You're only going in just to have your cervix checked.
And sometimes they don't think to ask you because douching is so old school, which some of us was taught to do. You know, they don't think to ask you, are you douching?
The vagina is not supposed to smell like sunrise, flowers, roses, and candy.
If you eat right, it'll smell and taste right. But men can carry the BV bacteria
in their penis. So, if you have BV and you get the diagnosis and you don't tell your man and you give it to him, now he's carrying it around. And guess what? When you're done with your treatment,
you got it right back.
You're
going to
get it again.
You know the movie that come to mind when, what was that?
Ooh.
What was that Tyler Perry movie? She's like, bam, I got my shot.
Hey.
I got something too.
Another one of those.
I've been treated.
One of those gifts that keeps on giving
y'all
if you don't do something about it.
Yeah.
So be honest, if like I said before, if you're sleeping with multiple people, you need to let everybody know that as a woman that you have BV and they all need to be treated. Like I said, the doctors.
And these men don't be acting like they out here acting like they got one girlfriend and they thinking they're a sideline player.
And I just want to throw out there, since she just said that, as a man, that we're telling you what you can be tested for, but there is something you cannot be tested for, or it is not very common to be tested for. So in my research with HPV, there is a urine test, but it's not reliable. So women have to actually get a pap smear that includes the HPV test, because a pap smear sometimes only looks for abnormal cell changes.
Exactly.
Not testing HPV.
Exactly.
So if they just do a pap with no HPV testing, which happens, you won't know.
Exactly.
Be clear and specific. I want HPV testing with my pap smear.
And one more key point for the men. Bacterial vaginosis is a matter of cleanliness as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not just the bacteria that's sticking around. It's you're not being clean about. You're not cleaning, especially if you haven't been circumcised. It can stick around there as well. Okay.
And Marcus wouldn't let us do a demonstration on how to clean that thing.
We was gonna clean, we was gonna prime.
So we can't show y'all that.
Clean, she cutting up tonight. We gonna go to commercial and pay some bills while Gabby goes to the corner to sit.
You are now tuned in with PBG of Nurse Notes.
Hi, I'm Pam.
I'm Veronica.
And I'm Gabby. And we are here to get you
notarized.
Catch our all-new podcast
every Thursday night from 7 to 8 p.m.
on YouTube, Official Nurse Notes, and Villa Cooler Radio.
You can also watch us on our website at www.officialnursenotes.com.
Please go like, follow, and share on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
See you there, Notees!
Thank you so much for joining tonight's show.
Man.
Sexually transmitted infections.
Infestations.
I thought y'all had those a song two. For them.
We're going to give them a little songy song.
Yeah.
Let's talk about
sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad things that may be. Let's talk about sex.
Come on, Nurse Mo.
Let's talk about sex.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about
ladies,
sex.
All the ladies.
See?
Loud and now, help me out. Come on, all the ladies.
Where you at, pal?
Huh?
So, I hope y'all
this is never a trio.
Never.
Producer.
I hope y'all all enjoyed this very informative video. If you did, please like, comment, share, subscribe. We do have a lot of comments. Hey, Nariah.
Hey, Nariah. That's our social media manager, y'all.
Hey, girl.
Hey,
Stephanie.
Nariah.
Stephanie, thanks for the comments.
Tamika,
the makeup artist.
Yes.
Of the year.
Yes.
Hey, girl.
Hey.
Thank y'all so much.
She's the beat queen, for real.
Yes.
Okay.
Please share this on your personal pages. Please let people know what we're doing over here on Nurse Notes.
Have conversation parties. I mean, y'all ain't got nothing to do. Get together, talk about it.
Y'all are productive citizens in America.
No.
While you're being productive, go ahead and subscribe.
I was going to say, in Nurse Notes,
get in the corner.
The business page, we actually got 200 plus likes on the business page on Facebook. So thank y'all.
Thanks, Notees.
New subscribers on our YouTube.
Yes.
So this is working. Please continue to share. We appreciate it.
We want to be a STI. Virally on YouTube. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all have a great night.
That was the show.
Every Thursday night, same place, same time.
I can't say that.